Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. This week I'm delving into that dangerous area of Siri shortcuts, or Apple shortcuts in particular. Now, the way I decided to do this is to show you the shortcuts that I use on a regular basis. This is not going to be a tutorial on how to set up to shortcuts, because it is a deep, deep, deep subject, and there are far better videos out there that will show you how to set up more complicated shortcuts, if you like. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the ones that I use on a regular basis, how it incorporates into my day, and hopefully that will give you some ideas on what you can do with shortcuts yourself. Now, before we go any further, let me just ask, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips and tricks using Apple's tools for productivity, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Apple shortcuts now and show you just the ones that I use on a regular basis. Okay, so here we have my iPad today, and I'm going to show you exactly what shortcuts I actually use. Now, just to let you know that shortcuts are done through the iCloud, so that anything I create on my iPad will also be automatically created on my iPhone. So let's go ahead and just open up shortcuts. Now, I don't actually have that many shortcuts set up in my shortcuts list, but what I do have is a couple of ones that I use every day. And the way that I've done this is I've added these to my widgets. So if I just come out of this now and just drag up here, you can see that I have my widgets here. Now, I use this because every single morning I can set this up straight away. I can go straight into this and it really just helps me to get started. So the first thing is I use meditation. Now, meditation is something that I actually use to set up my meditation. So I make my coffee and then I do 10 minutes meditation in the morning. Now, instead of going hunting for a playlist, this is doing through Apple Music, what I do is I just tap this and that will start off my musical playlist. And what it's going to do is it's going to start playing this album here, which is Above and Beyond's Flow State, which essentially is a meditation playlist. And I've for some reason, whenever I'm connected to ScreenFlow, which is the app I use to record my screens, this doesn't seem to actually play the volume, which is fine by me. But there you go. That's ScreenFlow, and that's this is how I use for the start off in the morning. So I'll just stop that because it's no point in playing it. The next one that I use is my daily template. Now, my daily template, by the way, if you're curious, if I just go in here, essentially what you do is you go into apps, and I'm going to show you this in a moment, but you go into apps, pick Apple Music, and then that will, you can then just, from here, you can just choose which song. But we'll come into that in a moment. Next one I have is my daily template, and this is for my day one journal. And once I've finished my meditation, the next thing I do is I actually check my email, because I'm based in Asia, and most of my clients and customers are based in Europe and the US, so I get most of my emails through the night. So I want to know what's going on in case there's anything urgent. But what I do then, once I've done my email, I go in and I start create my daily template in OneNote. And essentially, all I have to do, and again, I don't actually have to do it from shortcuts, I just do it from this. So I hit that daily template, that will now open up a daily template. And what you've got in here is you've got the what I accomplished today, and I just tap that in, and then my checklist, and that just brings that up every single morning. So that's the way that I do that. So that's a really cool way of doing getting straight to my day one morning template. I also have one that I haven't used for a long time, but it's my daily priming one. I tap that and it will give me my list of all the things that I want to do first thing in the morning. It's just a great way of actually getting tasks, just seeing my checklist for the morning. And that just is there just to see, just to make sure that everything is working, you know, going properly. I haven't used that one for a while. The next one up is what I usually play every morning, which is a playlist that I play. It's kind of, I call it my energizer, and I just tap that, and that will set me off playing the energizer. So essentially, how do you set these up? So these are all the ones that I'm using every single day. Another one, by the way, that I have in here is I've got my what's today's focus, and I can actually ask Siri to say that. So I can just sort of go, are you ready? By the way, just make sure that Siri is not listening to me, because because I'm just about to initiate Siri. So please turn over your phones. I'm going to say that word that's going to engage Siri. Hey Siri, what's today's focus? And because the microphone is not working either, this isn't going to work. But actually, on my phone, that's what I can do. I just realized that as soon as I've plugged into my Siri switches off. Oh, the settings I've got. So anyway, but really all I have to do is this. And I'm just going to take you into this one. So essentially what I've done here is show all my tasks for today's focus. And that's all I have to do. But you can actually add these. So when you tap in here, you see the three dots at the top. This one up here is the phrase that you use to engage Siri. So what's today's focus? That's all I have to do to say to Siri, and she will then show me. If I run this, you'll see what it does. It brings up my today's focus in here. So that's all done. That's right up to date. Just a wonderful, quick way of doing that. On your phone, that's something I use all the time. So how do you create these shortcuts? Now, unless you're very good at programming, or you've just got that kind of mind that can work if this, then do that sort of thing. And if you've been using those, then that it works in a very similar way. The way to get started with shortcuts is to go to your apps. Now, the one that everyone asked me about last week was my Drafts app, which I will just go back in here and show you. We'll go back to shortcuts. My Drafts app, which is the, where's my shortcuts? Go back. Done. So my Drafts app, which is take a note. So as soon as I tap that, it brings up the dictation, and that creates then the notes. I'm going to cancel that because we don't want to do that. Let's go back to shortcuts. So what that one is if I tap on the three dots, I've got dictate new draft, and the take a note is the phrase that I use for Siri. So you just type that in there, take a note, and that's what she will do. Again, as I say, I'm on my iPad. So how to get these? How do you get these types of Siri shortcuts? So the thing to do is go to your apps up here. So let's just go done. So this is when you open up shortcuts, this is what you will see. If you tap on the top right hand corner there, you've got the plus. You tap on that and it will bring up suggestions here. So there's loads of suggestions with apps that I use regularly. But I'm going to tap on apps. And if you go down to drafts, what you'll see is I've got one here where it says dictate new draft right down there at the bottom. If I tap that, it brings up the actual shortcut. If I tap on it, so that's all I need to do. Now again, I can add that to this to shortcuts, which I'm going to do, which I've already done actually. So I'm going to get rid of that. But then if I tap on that, I can now type in hey, you know, take a note or add a draft, whatever I want to add, and then that's the key phrase that you use with Siri. Now you're very lucky because I'm doing this on my iPad today. I'm not going to be able to get Siri to engage. And last week everyone was complaining anyway because I was kept saying that phrase to engage Siri and it was setting everyone's off. But what you'll see down here is you get lots of options and then you can just play with them. But remember, when you want to activate it as a Siri shortcut, you need to hit the three dots there and type in the shortcut name. That way you will get Siri to action it. So if I just go back here and we'll go back to my, oops, don't want to do that, cancel that. Let's just go back. So we'll cancel that. Delete shortcut because I've already got one. So if I just go in here, you can see that I've got dictate new draft, and in there I've got take a note. That's basically all it is. So I'm done. Like play my Energizer checklist, which is here. So let's tap on that. If I tap on this, play Energizer. That's all I have to say, and Siri will do it. Now there's a couple of things when you're doing music. When you hit show more, you can now shuffle the songs and repeat all. Now for those of you in the Todoist phrase, again, you've got the Todoist one, and if I just tap there, if I just go into the plus, tap apps and go down to my Todoist. Todoist has a lot of options, and actually when you have your filters in there, it actually includes the filter. So a lot of my filters are in there, so you can actually do that. So for example, open project or open label, you've got lots of options there. So that's essentially the basics of using shortcuts. Now if you're using them on the iPad like I do, and I use them a lot, you can add them to your shortcuts widget. So you can go down here, you can add, you know, you can add the widgets here, and you can keep them on your home screen by tapping that. That is super, super useful, and you can actually extend that so you can have them all in there, and boom, you're ready to go. It's just such a super thing. I would recommend playing with it. It took me quite a long time to actually really understand what I wanted to do to get the most out of it. But anyway, that's the way that it actually works. So there you go. That's how I use shortcuts. That's basically how I set up the to drafts shortcut, as I showed you today. And these are the ones that I use on a regular basis. I hope you got some value from this. Thank you very much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I'd like to introduce you to a brand new way of managing your tasks. Now, this system is called the Time Sector System. It's designed to do away with your projects, to do away with your goals, or at least do away with them from your time management system, your to-do list manager, and instead focuses on when you are going to do the task. Now, the reason for this is from a research that I did for the whole of last year, figuring out why most people were really struggling with their tasks, getting their tasks done on a day-to-day basis. What I discovered was they were managing their tasks by project. And the biggest problem with managing tasks by project is, first of all, deciding whether a task is a project or not. Two or more tasks becomes a project, which means that you end up with a huge project list. And once you have a huge project list, just managing that list takes up an awesome amount of time. Time you could well better be spent actually doing the work, not organizing. The time sector method is designed to do away with all that processing so that the only decision you have to make is when are you going to do a task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, how urgent a task is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. So the whole clip, this, I have launched a brand new course that gives you the step-by-step approach of setting up the time sector method. It's a revolutionary course. It's designed for the 21st century. For all the inputs that we get today, all the emails, the Slack messages, and everything else that comes our way, it's designed to deal with that, to manage that, so you stay focused on what you have identified are your most important tasks for the day. I'd love to see you in the course. Full details of the course are in the show notes below. I'd love you to check it out. Join me in the course and let's take your productivity to a greater level than you've ever, ever imagined. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. I just wish you all a very, very productive week.